Thank you. I'm sorry I was briefing AFET on the next Foreign Affairs Council, so I guess also many of your colleagues are just moving from one room to the other to hear. Some were faster than me. Permettez-moi de commencer en français.
May I begin in French?
And
have a thought for the atrocious acts that were committed last week in Paris. We've experienced pain, solidarity with the victims, condolences, support for the victims and their families. Of course, there have been reactions from the French, primarily French European institutions. Europeans and the whole world have reacted, expressing unity, a balance, and strength, above all strength. And in the weeks and months to come, we have the time to build on that reaction and learn from the past.
It is not the first time that out of a tragedy we are able to build positive things. Actually, the European Union was born on the ruins of the Second World War. And out of our main tragedy, our founding fathers, one of whom today resigned as the President of the Italian Republic, were brave and wise enough to be able to build the most successful experience of regional integration in history. And that experience was recognized with the Nobel Peace Prize. Now, if you don't want our Europe to turn into history and be confined in the past, I think we have to be as brave and as wise as our founding fathers were able to be. Out of the tragedy that happened exactly 1 week ago, if I'm not wrong, in Paris, we have the duty to rebuild our European Union. And stating our unity, our strength, our solidarity, and starting from our strength, our unity, and our solidarity, starting somehow from ourselves. You might think that this has nothing to do with our debate today, but I believe it does. I believe that what happened last week is showing to all European Union citizens and many outside of our borders the first lesson we have to learn, which is that you need to be more united and really united, not only at words, not only on papers, but in practice. We need to trust each other when it comes to sharing information, when it comes to foreign policy, when it comes to defense, when it comes to security. We have to understand that we share much more than what divides us, and that it's in our interest, it's in our citizens' interest, when it comes to security, when it comes to economic prosperity, when it comes to freedom and rights, it is our interest to work really together, closely, and become cooperative and not competitive among us, as I think was shown yesterday and again today very well. We're trying to work in a cooperative and non-competitive way among European institutions here, Parliament, Council and Commission. The second lesson that I think we have to learn is that there is no real border between external and internal events. And so there must be no real border between our external and internal action. That is the reason why we're trying to coordinate, and I'm personally trying to coordinate our work within the Commission and within the Council. I have started doing that already in these first 2 months, and I'm planning to do it even more in a broader sense when it comes to foreign policy, security policy, defense policy, but also security internally, counterterrorism, but also justice, or other challenges that we have in front of us, being it migration, being it energy, climate, transport, trade, economy, but even culture and education. Again, some of you might think, what does it have to do with our foreign security policy? Well, let me say, this is the core, I think, of our security policy, to understand that security is not purely a security, a securitarian issue. It is also a security issue, it is also a defense issue, but it is also a human security issue. And this has to take into consideration all aspects of everybody's life. In general, I think we have to look at all the main challenges with a coordinated approach. And this is going to be one of the challenges of our foreign and security policy in the months ahead. We preach policy coherence when it comes to development and cooperation, for instance, but then we hardly do it when it comes to ourselves. And I think we should take a slogan out of a famous brand, just do it, and try to be coherent and consistent ourselves. Third lesson I think we need to work on in the coming months on foreign security policy is that there is no simple answer to complex problems. And if you look around us, being it close in our region or far away, we see complexity as the first element. That is evident on the Middle East, and let me take this opportunity for thanking this Parliament for an excellent work over the months of November and December on the resolution on the Middle East, this process, and on the very fruitful debate we had, and also resolution that passed, that I think was very helpful. But there is no single problem that is a white and black issue around us. And this means that we need, on one side, as I said, a mix of measures and instruments, and making sure that all the things we do go into a coherent approach, but also requires a deep, maybe a deeper understanding of what is happening inside the European Union, around the European Union, and also far away from the European Union. And for doing that, we probably need to develop some cultural instruments inside our borders. We tend to use categories of thought that are still the ones we had in the last century. And this has nothing to do with East and West. This has to do with our identity, our models of life in society, and our relation to other countries. When it comes to diplomacy, we sure have the usual instruments of diplomacy. We have the new instruments of diplomacy, digital diplomacy and so on. But I think we are sometimes using still the old categories of relating with other countries, with other organizations, with other regions of the world, with old ways of projecting our image of the European Union that is probably not corresponding anymore to the reality of history. Other point we need, and that is really crucial for following up the tragic events in Paris, we need to develop a mix of immediate actions and long-term strategies. We tend to react to whatever comes in immediate terms. Then how effective we are on delivering on the immediate terms is another story, and this requires also deep thinking of the functioning of our institutions, I think. This is not for today. But then sometimes, or often, we lack long-term strategies, long-term visions. And we, on that, I think, need to engage seriously in the coming months with our partners around us. Starting, we just discussed that in AFET, in a restricted format, engaging very much with countries that do have a knowledge that is deeper than ours, but maybe don't have the same instruments that we have to tackle the issues on which their knowledge applies, being it at east of our borders, being it at the south or in the Gulf. But most of all, I think that we have to make a cultural change internally ourselves. What I was surprised about Sunday in Paris, and I'm sorry if I take it personal, but I think that's also part of our political and institutional life, was the image of hundreds, thousands of citizens in Paris clapping at the leaders as the leaders were showing unity, solidarity, and presence, physical presence together. And this image of citizens of a country that has had been attacked only a few days before, with a sense of tension and difficulties inside, clapping at somehow a picture of Europe, is something that I think we have to keep in our minds and in our hearts. Because this is questioning us here. We tend to have debates, I cannot say so much about this hemicycle, but I've been listening quite a lot in these months. But we tend to have an image of Europe as something little, limited, very partial, very weak. That might be the case, but that image of French citizens clapping at the image of Europeans, standing strong and together, has to give us the responsibility to work on our own perception of our power. And I will use the word power, which is not a usual European word. We normally tend to be humble, and this is good. This is good. One can be a power, one can be even a superpower, using that with a sense of being humble and facilitate dialogue and mediation. And yes, we are a superpower. We are a superpower that won the Nobel Peace Prize. And I think that the major responsibility and lesson we are to draw about what happened in these weeks is that we have to be the major superpower for action for peace, for action for human rights, dialogue and respect. Knowing that peace, knowing as only Europeans know, that peace is not only the absence of war, peace is also respect and promotion of human rights, security and equality. I don't know if that answers the question of what kind of foreign policy challenges we have in front of us. If you want, I have a long list, 23 pages actually, of single issues and single countries and our concrete engagement on each and every of these issues and these countries and these regions. I would tend not to go through that list, but just to say that there is not one single global issue or region of the world or country in the world where we can afford, as Europeans, not to increase our presence, our role as actors for peace. I would obviously be ready to go through that list with a selective approach, probably because 23 pages would make us stay here even longer than the midnight that is at the moment foreseen. But afterwards, after your interventions in my reply, to be more specific on many of the issues that we have been debating very precisely in these months, these 2.5 months, I think I've been meeting you in different formats, probably some 15, 16 times, and again yesterday on Libya and today on many other of the issues that are the top priority issues of today for the European Union. And we have other three chances, I think, to go on a strategic, complete discussion in the next months here in this chamber. One is when we will discuss the Brok report quite soon. And that, I think, will be a very good chance to go through a strategic debate and review in depth. And we started to do that with the national parliaments as well. Second is going to be the preparation for the June European Council, where I will have the responsibility of presenting an assessment on global security. And let me also share with you the fact that, third element, I believe that that will be also the chance of starting a process to have a new security strategy for the European Union. And let me also add that rather than having a security strategy, I would suggest that we will have a foreign policy and security strategy, because we need to have that coherent and large approach also when we debate about our own strategies for the future. Let me conclude in this way, but just by saying that I know that some of you might have expected me to go through that 23 pages list, and again, to remind that I am ready to discuss, being it our engagement with Latin America, where I will be in a couple of weeks' time to prepare the EU-CELAC summit, climate change, where we will have a Monday an action plan for diplomacy to prepare the Paris summit in December, being it counter-terrorism, again, where we will have a coordinated work with the Interior and Justice Ministers, but also, I think, an intercultural and interreligious exercise to be developed over the next months, more on the internal side, but also involving actors in the region, or being it, obviously, a discussion on Ukraine and Russia that we will have just after this discussion today, or being it our relations to Asia or to Africa, where again I will be participating to the African Union summit in less than 2 weeks, or our relations to the United States, that normally is automatically associated with the negotiations for TTIP, which is something we can discuss, obviously, but we also have to be aware of the fact that a lot of the strategies and the challenges that we have in front of us will be needed to be developed together with a partner that is probably going through also difficult times as well as we are. And most of all, let me say that for me, what is also crucial today is listening from you. I know this is mainly a chance for you to put questions, but let me say that for me, the most precious time here in this chamber is taking notes of what you say. I thank you very much.